It was out of character for a former Bureau of Corrections OIC and National Bureau of Investigation official to shed tears. But in this interview, Rafael Ragos, a key witness to the government's drug case against detained Senator Laila de Lima, could barely finish his sentences as he apologized profusely to his former boss.
Hindi ko ginusto ito. Pasensya na. May mainit din sa dibdib ko na nakakapag-agrabya. Ang grabya na tayo ng tao. Nag-agrabyado po ako ng tao.
In 2016, Ragos testified before the House of Representatives and subsequently in court, accusing de Lima of receiving 10 million pesos in drug payoffs in November and December 2012 when she was still Justice Secretary. That money, allegedly delivered to de Lima's house in Parañaque, was supposedly her share in the illegal drug trade at the New Bilibid prison. Ragos's and his aide Jovencio Ablen Jr.'s testimonies were instrumental in keeping one drug case against de Lima alive, even as the same court junked another drug case against her. But 5 years since making the claim, Ragos is now saying none of it happened. Instead, Ragos accused former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre of pressuring him to testify against de Lima. Aguirre allegedly called for a meeting at a casino hotel in Parañaque to force him to sign an affidavit implicating de Lima.
Ang taong mismong nag-call sa akin ay si Secretary Aguirre and his companies. Anyway, tinabag ako ni Secretary Aguirre again. Sabi sa akin, you have to execute an affidavit. Alam mo na mangyayari. Knowing na wala na akong kawala, captive ako in that instance. I told him, okay, I approve.
Rago said he was forced to sign out of fear for his life and his family's safety and because he was implicated in one of the drug cases against de Lima. He was later dropped as one of the accused after he agreed to testify. He was also set free after being detained for 7 months. Ragos's lawyer said he had been considering the retraction for some time.
The vindication of a burdened conscience has no expiry date. And his statements implicating Senator de Lima has been weighing on him for the longest time. He wanted to come clean. He could not live with himself having to live with the knowledge that 5 years of illegal detention is on him. You can only imagine the level of duress he was working under.
But the Justice Department sees little value in Ragos's retraction. It says the testimonies of other witnesses in the case are enough to prove the charges against de Lima and her former bodyguard, Ronnie Dayan. It also clarifies it did not use Ragos as a witness in the other pending drug case against de Lima. Prosecutor General Benedicto Malcontento adds, the affidavit hasn't even been presented in court yet.
Until such time na naipasok yung huling affidavit ni Ragos, walang effect itong latest affidavit na ito. Kahit na maipasok yung huling affidavit na yan, hindi automatic yan na itong huling affidavit ang paniniwalaan. No. Ang jurisprudence natin dyan, i-evaluate ngayon ng huwes as between two conflicting affidavits, alin ang paniniwalaan ng husgado.
But for de Lima's spokesperson, Ragos's retraction will affect all the pending cases, especially since it comes days after self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa retracted all his allegations against de Lima last week. Unlike Espinosa, who testified in the Senate, Ragos testified in court.
Now, their main star witness has now recanted. This consistently shows the political persecution of Senator Laila de Lima is well orchestrated, and in fact, the entire machinery of the state was used in order to make sure that she rots in jail.
De Lima's lawyer challenges the Justice Department to withdraw all the charges against the senator.
Will the Department of Justice now do the right thing to reinvestigate the case and hopefully to withdraw the charges against Senator Laila de Lima, more to Proprio, and more importantly, to investigate their own ranks who have been involved in this sinister plot and the greatest frame-up in Philippine history against a particular individual. It is important for the Department of Justice to do the right thing.
In a statement, De Lima thanked Ragos for owning up to his false testimony and for naming the personalities behind the conspiracy to destroy her reputation and to put her in jail. De Lima said she always knew former Justice Chief Vitaliano Aguirre was the leading instigator of the fabricated cases against her, next only to President Duterte. The senator is hoping that with Espinosa's and Ragos's retractions, Filipinos will finally see the conspiracy among government officials from the legislative and executive branches. Ragos's lawyer says he is ready to allow De Lima's team to use his affidavit if needed.
This affidavit will be made available to the lawyers, to the defense lawyers of Senator De Lima, if should they wish to have access to it. It can be used, in fact, to check prosecutorial misconduct. I mean, there are statements here showing very clearly how some prosecutors are creating their own evidence. I mean, they are the Department of Justice. Is this justice?
Facing calls to probe alleged coercion and intimidation committed by justice officials, Justice Secretary Minado Guevara says he will refer the affidavit alleging improper behavior of DOJ officials to another agency, the Office of the Ombudsman, for appropriate action. The DOJ, he says, has yet to receive a copy of Ragos's affidavit. Malacanang keeping its hands off the case against Senator Laila De Lima. Acting Presidential Spokesperson Martin Andanar says Malacanang respects the independence of the court handling the senator's case. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.